Let us discuss types of collisions based on material properties. Here we can write, based on types of material, a physical material which we use in different kind of objects, collisions can be classified in three categories. These are, first one is elastic collision, number two is partial elastic collision, and the third one is inelastic collisions. The basic difference in the three collisions, for any case of impact, you can simply state, when we talk about elastic collision, here we write kinetic energy loss is equal to zero during collision. Here we talk about during collision, kinetic energy loss is zero. Partial elastic collision we can signify as some kinetic energy loss. In case of inelastic collision, kinetic energy loss is maximum. Up to the extent it can be lost, it is lost. I think all of you can recall just now, in the previous article we have studied, when two balls come in contact, if they are thrown in such a way that they are moving along the same line of motion with the speeds u1 and u2 such that u1 is more than u2, the two balls come in contact, and an intermediate instant, a situation arises when the two balls would be moving with the same speed. This is the state of minimum kinetic energy. Here you can state, when inelastic collision takes place, kinetic energy loss is maximum. This is the minimum kinetic energy which must be there in the balls to move or to conserve momentum. Afterwards, no gain in kinetic energy will take place. In case of partial elastic collision, some kinetic energy will increase. And in case of elastic collision, you can simply write, if some initial kinetic energy is there, and finally in the ball, some final kinetic energy is there. So you can write, in case of elastic collision, kinetic energy final is equal to kinetic energy initial of all the bodies involved in the collision. In partial elastic collision, kinetic energy final is less than kinetic energy initial. In case of inelastic collision, also final kinetic energy will be less. Here also final kinetic energy will be less than initial kinetic energy. But here final kinetic energy, you can simply state, will be the minimum kinetic energy which was there at the state of minimum separation between the balls, or in the state of minimum kinetic energy. Let's discuss different type of materials first, based on which we define the three type of collisions. So now let's discuss classification of solids. Basically, all type of solids are divided in three different kind of materials, which are elastic material, partially elastic material, and inelastic material. Inelastic materials are also termed as plastic materials. Let's discuss all these three type of material and their characteristics one by one. We first take up elastic material. We can write, these are the material which deform on application of external force and regains original shape on removal of force. Like for example, say we are having a material block. If a force is applied onto it, if the material is elastic due to the application of force, the block deforms like this. Due to the force, if the block is fixed, due to the application of force on one side, the block deforms. When we remove the force, the block will regain its original shape. In this situation, we can say on applying the force, say the force produces a deformation X in the system. So we can say the force has done F into X amount of work. Or in deformation, the force or the agent who is applying the force has supplied an energy equal to Fx to the block. So we can simply state here deformation means potential energy is stored in the block. Because when we supply some energy to the system, what happens? Energy is stored in the block or in the system. Or we can say in all elastic materials, when some force is applied, they store potential energy which is equal to the amount of work done in deformation. And when force is removed, we can simply state on removal of force, this potential energy is released. The block will regain the shape and releases the potential energy which can be used in many ways. Like it can be used in doing work on other object, it can be transformed in form of kinetic energy or any other phenomena. But we must be careful, elastic material is the one in which no dissipation of energy takes place. When deformation occurs, the body which is made up of elastic material stores potential energy, and when deformation is restored, complete potential energy is released, no loss of energy takes place in case of elastic materials. Let's see what are partially elastic material. As we have discussed that elastic material are those in which when some work is done in deformation of an object, it will be stored in form of potential energy which can be released completely on removal of external force. Here we write, in case of partially elastic material, work done in deformation, we can write that it is partly stored in form of potential energy. That means if we are having an object and we apply an external force onto it, say if the object is fixed, due to the external force, say it is deformed. Now in this situation, say the deformation is X and the work done by the external force is integration of F dx from 0 to X, and this is the total work done. But in the deformation, this complete work is not stored in form of potential energy. Always the stored potential energy will be less than the work done, because some amount of work is lost against lattice friction of the molecules, or lattice friction between the molecules during displacement of these molecules over each other. So we can state in this situation, the amount of work done is partly stored in form of potential energy, and the remaining energy is dissipated. And when we remove this force, we can simply write on removal of external force, only the stored potential energy will be released. Thus, in case of partially elastic materials, whenever some work is done on deformation of the objects, complete work will never be recovered in form of kinetic energy or in any other form. During deformation, some amount is dissipated against lattice friction which cannot be recovered, and the amount of work which is stored in form of potential energy, that is only released by the object which can be reused again. Similarly, the third category of materials are inelastic materials. For inelastic materials, we can state whenever some work is done in deformation of an object, we can write it is completely dissipated and it can never be recovered. And as the complete amount of work is dissipated, and we can say no potential energy is stored, this implies we can write that on removal of force, object remain in deformed state. If there is an object and we apply a force, in this situation due to the force some deformation is there. When we remove the force, the object remain in deformed state, it will not recover because there is no potential energy which can be released. So here we can state no restoring force exists in inelastic materials, whereas in case of elastic and partially elastic materials, some restoring force exists due to which it has a tendency to bring the body back in its normal state up to some extent or completely, depending whether the material is partially elastic or it is completely elastic.